to improve the situation over here. So this is my second panel. Tamadin is looking this side, but I must finish. there are more pending things which I want that people should get it. And I will fight, even from Allahabad, I will fight for them. And there are things for which my main thing in college was to help people to think and to be creative. All that has happened at school level, where rote memory is taken, so my job was to make them unlearn and see to it that we have people who can think and who are creative. Today we don't have people who think, and that is why we find politicians leading us who are of such nature. It is our responsibility. So thinking and being creative is very dear to me. And any student, you may not like me also, is great, my greatest friend. Any teacher who is of this type is my greatest friend. So my friendship doesn't go by face cards. My friendship doesn't go by that. Though we have had very pretty girls, you can see Kimberly who spoke here, and so many other students who have been very pretty at heart and very pretty outwardly also. So we are very grateful to all these students for their contribution. I was thinking about creativity. Yesterday I went to Margao, in fact to my native place in Avelin, Kepen, from where Deobarkar, his grandmother hails from there, we discovered much later. And people say that Goans are not good entrepreneurs. They are saying that. They are only good to go to Kuwait and work there. And when I went by this new highway in Agassain, I saw 30 people selling vegetables which are very specific to Agassain, what you call Akshichin Konga and Akshichin Wangin and many other things. So you don't call this entrepreneurship. They are sitting there in the hot sun. Now all of you think how you can help them, how you can improve their lot. Can we have something that's a, it's a highway, you cannot have it, where they can sell things properly? Can you think about that? And you might be thinking that this man is thinking about this type of ideas I used to throw to my students. So some of them used to think, what Akshichin Wangi has got with our MA and our studies, nothing. But this is what is very important, quite important to do. Second thing is, I have made a plan for next 20 years. So if you don't make plans for 20 years, definitely it means you are not going to expect that you are going to live that long. It is always like that, you know. I miss very much today here my father, my mother and my wife, who were good support to me. I learned Portuguese at the feet of my father and my mother. And I learned French and Latin at the feet of my father, and English at the feet of my father. And like Dr. Digambar got a slab, so all of us of that period at least got slab. I am not giving to my children, but we got slab. Once you will remember, I can tell you when I was small, maybe in second, maybe fourth standard or third standard, I don't remember. My father was very much annoyed with me because I had arithmetic I never liked. So I had problem. If you require three men to paint this wall and in 4 days and 5 days of paint, so you tell how much that is, I don't know. So there was one carpenter working. So he sent me to the shop asking him, how can he bring me, say, bezo? So like a silly fellow, I must confess, I went to the shop and presence of all those people, I said, give me bezo. So you can imagine that people who reach to a certain level are not people who fallen from above, are people like me of such type of situations that we have got. My father and my wife, they have been always after me to do my PhD, but I could never satisfy them. Not that I didn't try, I got admission to go to States to do my PhD. I got scholarship also at Marquette University. But when I went to the consulate for visa, they told me, at that time I was 29. They said, you are 29 and not yet married, Who says that you will come back and not marry some American there? Sorry, no visa for you. And at my side, there was another Gujarati lady with very dirty slippers and did not even check her thing, says, welcome to United States. So I was wondering what this logic these Americans have got. And I missed it. Then I tried a second time at University of Bombay. I was admitted. And there was a tussle between head of department and my guide. And I was the victim, so I had to live there. This is the situation in our universities. Either you have to become their friend and their stooge, or you don't get PhD. And many girls tell me that they have harrowing times in different universities when they do PhD with men folk, and what are the experiences that they are getting. I have first-hand experience of that, which is very bad. I don't like it. Then I have been, my father was very strict, but then I decided that I will use different technique with my children. And I had problem with my wife. She was saying that you are using your psychology, no use. But I persisted. And I found out that the results my father had got, I got also. But not with that. My first, I had animosity for my father for a certain period. Then we became best of friends. That happens to everybody because of generation gap. But that I didn't allow to happen with my children. I am not disappointed. And I feel they are going to be worthy of my name. That I am sure. My son could not come. He is in Panipat during final year of engineering. My daughter, who is doing diploma in business administration at Goa Institute of Management, Ribandar, she told me that if she remains absent, she will lose her grades. So as a good teacher, I said, don't come. But then she phoned me, she can come. Is she there? Elaine is there. So she said that sometimes I can bunk even though whatever matters is for the grade. Whatever, but that bunking is not like our college bunking. Here they means reduce the grade. And my younger son told him, never mention that I am here, my name, nothing about me. And he said, I know that you will mention. So I have been very much, I have been blessed. I always count my blessings. And after the loss of my wife, and even before, my mother-in-law has been great strength. She is the one who is managing. She is the one who came here to give the gold medals. And that is why I could go to Allahabad. Otherwise, I would not. So I always pray that she should be healthy and she should have long life. So that I can do many things in different places, depending on her. And third very important thing that I have got in mind, I have realized that if I had studied management, scientific management, I would have become better principal. I have realized that. I have used my natural management. As all Posarkar's shopkeepers do, they use their management and they make money. But those who study scientific management, either they study themselves or employ people with all these degrees, and they do much better. So I realized that all headmasters of schools, all principals of high secondaries, all principals of colleges, all vice-chancellors of universities should undergo a management course. Without that, much of today, I can tell you 80% of our universities are substandard. And one of the reasons for that is this. Because they don't know what is management. Just by writing scientific papers, you cannot manage an institution. Just by holding a degree, you cannot hold people together. You require to learn what others have learned. England passed through this stage, and about 15 years back, they started special institutions to train. So my major plan during these 20 years is to start an institution where specifically, management training is going to be imparted to people who want to become headmasters of school and principals of colleges and vice-chancellors of universities. Just to help the education to be more scientific rather than the way that we are doing. We have achieved results, but we would have achieved much more if this was I know it is late, and I thank very much all of you for being present over here. But my special thanks to Mr. Sanjay Harmalkar. So I told him I cannot be contained in this portrait. I must go out from there. When I told him that he should not be so big and all that, people will think that he thinks he is the governor. And he said, he is a very simple man. He said, you are a big man, he told me. So I don't know, but he is telling like that. So I accepted his gift. And the gold medals that